As time wore on, her wild policy of self-experimentation grew intolerable. She quaffed all manner of strange fungi, herbs, and concoctions, intent on gaining some insight into the horror we both knew to be growing beneath us. The change in her was appalling, and no longer able to stomach it, I sent her to live in the Weald, where her wildness would be welcomed. There is method in the wild corruption here. It bears a form both wretched and malevolent. Some reward for a task well performed. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Eradicated. Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all. Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. Nature herself, a victim to the spreading corruption, malformed with misintent. Advantage. Give them no quarter. Decimated. glittering gold, trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood. Fortune waiting to be spent. Precision and power. Obliterated. Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Yes. death by inches. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike. Mortality clarified in a single strike. Devastating blow. Monster's size has no intrinsic merit, unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue. We'll be right back. These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten. Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won. Light, the promise of safety. The way is lit, the path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it. Twisted and maniacal, a slathering testament to the powers of corruption. Still poisoned. The way is still blocked, but less people will be eaten. We dug for months, years, an eternity, and we were rewarded with madness.